Since I talked about something relatively unknown last week, let's talk about something more accessible today. Hola! Today's manga is called Adabana and it's by the author No. It consists of 3 volumes and it was published from 2020 until 2021. Adabana means like fruitless flower, but it also means failure and unrequited love. That's just so you know. I personally haven't read anything else by this author, but a glance at the reviews of her other works indicate that people don't really like her stories. Like, they love her art, but the stories are kinda not so good. I gotta judge that for myself though, but that's just what I could gather. In any case, the story we'll be looking at today is pretty good. So, what happens? And also, I guess trigger warning, suicide, abuse, I think that's it. So the story starts with a young girl called Mizuki standing over the dead body of another girl, tears running down her face. Next, we see her at home, getting ready for school, talking to her very strict mother, who's always in her ear about school and the future. You know, the type. The TV is on and they already show the news of that girl being found, and we learn that her name was Mako. The mother talks about the incident, clearly worried about her own daughter, who just smiles at her and then leaves for school. In reality, she's actually headed to the police station to turn herself in. So there she confesses everything and she even brought the knife she killed Mako with her. They interrogate her and ask her why she did it, to which she replies that they had a fight. The police is immediately suspicious of her since, you know, normally you don't go up slicing people up just because you had an argument, you know? But even stranger, Mizuki says that Mako was her only friend. We then learn a little more about Mako and her past, and that she was a bright and sweet girl who was beloved by everybody. Her family doesn't have a lot of money, so she worked at a restaurant after school. So although her life wasn't easy, she always tried her best and was friendly all the time. Her existence was like an oasis for Mizuki, who felt like when she was with her, she could let go a little bit of the stress that her mother put her under. Even though Mako had less money than Mizuki, she even offered to pay for a ticket to Magical Land, some Disneyland-looking place, simply because Mizuki's mother wouldn't allow them to go, so now they had to sneak out and, you know. But then Mako introduces Mizuki to her boss at the restaurant, who's her uncle, by the way, like Mako's uncle, so that maybe Mizuki could work there as well and save up for this ticket. But the job turns out to be something a little different. That creep, the owner, Mako's uncle, he wants to take pictures of Mizuki in a swimsuit and, you know, sell them. She obviously refuses, which is when he starts attacking her in a sexual way. They struggle and Mizuki ends up slashing his throat and he dies. So she's killed somebody before. Mako arrives at the scene and they clean everything up together. And that is what happened in the first chapter, so I don't wanna spoil too much. I will say, however, that most of the story is set in the past. And with each chapter, we get to know more and more about the character and what really happened, because things aren't as they seemed at first. Especially after Mako's ex-boyfriend, Kira, no, a guy called Yuki, is introduced. So what do we think? First of all, the death of a young, beautiful girl is always a great opener, I think. It's very poetic and readers are immediately intrigued and, you know, want to know what happened and why. And when you do, once you get to know Mako, you can't help but like her. She's so pure and cute without being too childish and dumb. The love she has for Mizuki and the way she shows it with all these little things is really touching. But so is the love that Mizuki has for Mako as well. Their friendship is truly beautiful and also romantic in a sense. They both face their own hardships but find refuge in each other. Hold on, is it called refuge or refuge? Refuge. Sorry. The story is also set in a small town in the north, which makes it hard to get away from it all, you know? Because where would you go? I talked about this a little bit in my video on shonen nobis, but small town settings are very good for psychological stories like this one, because you feel even more trapped or locked in a cage, unable to run away from your problems. The terrible things they have to face are very realistic, and sadly, many young girls face similar problems. The tragic events throughout the manga are portrayed very realistically, I think. You just end up feeling really sad for the characters, because again, it's just much more realistic than many manga in this genre. The pacing of the story is also really good, I think. Three volumes are just the exact right length. Each chapter reveals a little more about everything. And you know, we get closer to the truth little by little. And man, I'm so glad I could binge read this, because it would have killed me to wait for the next chapter. It's really well written and just suspenseful. And it's amazing how attached I got to these characters after such a short amount of time. It was an intense read for sure. But again, I don't want to talk about it too much because I don't want to spoil it for you, so let's talk a little bit about the art as well. The art in this manga is just really good. Each panel looks great. The characters look cute, but also beautiful and mysterious at the same time. The facial expressions are just so good. And again, I think Mako's ex-boyfriend really looks like Kira. Even his personality reminded me of him a little bit, so in my head, they're the same person now. Anyways, I have no complaints here. The backgrounds are also very detailed and we see a lot of nature. This makes it really easy to immerse yourself in the story, and it feels like you know the town. Like you have a feeling of how big it is and where everything is, and as if you just live there. Honestly, the whole art in the manga is just perfect. Long story short, I can't recommend this manga enough if you like this kind of story and if you're into this genre, like mystery, psychological stuff, then definitely check it out, please. And when you do, let me know what you think about it. But for this week, that was all I wanted to share. I hope everybody has a great day, and I'll see you next week. Bye bye.